Okay, so we are going to take apart and replace the depower line on a Slingshot Guardian bar. First thing I'm going to do is open up the depower line like this. Pull this out of the cleat. We're going to take the end off this. We need a Phillips screwdriver to do that. And a fair bit of force. There we go. Unscrew that. Pull that out of there. Whoa. Okay. Now we want to remember how we put this together. We're also going to loosen these screws here. Looks like I brought some of the beach home with me. Okay, I got that loop there. We're taking the cleat off here. Pull that through there. There. So we know that this is going to go on that side, and this is going to go on that side. Stiff. We're all good. So, easy so far. Now you'll notice one side is thicker than the other side. This thin side goes through the one slot. Oh, I remember. Hang on. Need an Allen wrench. You need an Allen wrench too for that little piece right there. That'll start to move. You can go right up, I think. You pull this down through here, and then you can pull it out through the side. There we go. Okay. And then we can pull this off the end. So it helps to take the screw out, and then you really got to get this clear so you can get a line through there. Another good way to do it is to get some fishing line and a pair of scissors. The fishing line. Aptly named fishing line because we're going to use it as a fish. Hopefully. There we go. That we know needs to slide right up to where the line gets thin again. There we go. Right up to there, put the Allen wrench back in. Here we go. It's in there. Good. Just going to go up through here. Just going to come down through here. Just going to go through here. Like that. Next side of the line goes down on the other side. And in there, do a little fishing again. Goes in nice and easy. And you see there's two screws there. Pull the line out. So it's the line is actually only around one screw. Let's fit that in with a screwdriver just to wedge that in there. Okay. Perfect. Put that in. Where did that cleat go? There it is. Okay. Corroded cleat. I need that. I need to clean that up. Okay. I would recommend you clean that corrosion up a little bit. So you want to make sure that the bungee, maybe a bad idea to replace the bungee at the same time here. It's not in too bad a shape. This, you can see a little bit of wear through here. We'll do that in a minute. Yeah, we still haven't got this out of here yet. There we go. That's free. That away. So that's the wide side. You'll see two different hole diameters through that. That's gonna go like that. And then through here. That in through the narrow side. There we go. Okay, we're gonna fix this little issue where I installed the stopper above the little ball. And we're gonna do that very quickly. We're just gonna basically pull the stopper out the side, slide the ball up. Keep going there. Put the stopper back in. There we go. Slide the stopper down where it should be. There we go. And then put the little ball back in. Where are we? There. Come down through the bar. Okay, so that's gonna be on the top. That's on the right. And then I do like to do this with it all stretched out. It's a little bit more easy to follow. This is gonna go through here. The fish again. Tight, but it goes. Okay, let's make sure we got this all lined up properly here. Should be fine. Yep, all looks good. Okay, now actually, this is one of the trickier parts here, is putting this back on here. You gotta fish this up through here and then get the screw in there. And you actually want the screw to go through the loop. So you kinda gotta get the alignment right. So first we fish. There we go. So there's the screw there, and we want to have the rope twisted like that. Pull up through here. And you can just barely see that it's split there a little bit, which is what we want. That screw in. Bob's your uncle, pull the fish out. We're good. Put the butter box back together. Bungee back in place. And loose lines there so it all comes together nicely. And we are done. Voila.